there are shadows of the cross in the Old Testament. In Exodus chapter 12, we read about the passing over of the children of Israel led by Moses. And it's an account of how God protected the Israelites in Egypt from an angel of death. We read about what God told them to do. You know, he told them to take the blood of the lamb and apply it on their doorposts. And the blood of the lamb is extremely significant. Now, the Passover lamb was the reason why the death angel passed over the Israelites. However, the Bible teaches us in 1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 7, the scripture tells us, "Therefore, purge out the old leaven, that you may be a new lump, since you truly are unleavened. For indeed, Christ, our Passover, was sacrificed for us." And so the comparison here of the Passover lamb of Exodus chapter 12 is with Jesus Christ in the New Testament. And so Jesus is our Passover lamb. Whatever the Passover lamb did for the Israelites, Jesus has done for us. We are protected because of His blood. We are saved because of His blood. His blood has rescued us from the enemy. And therefore, you know, the blood of Jesus Christ and the sacrifice of Jesus is seen in the Old Testament. And so the Passover lamb is actually talking about Jesus, who would come later and fulfill what was just a shadow through the Passover lamb. There are many other pictures of the cross in the Old Testament. There's another one in Exodus chapter 17. And this is the time when the Israelites ask Moses to provide water. And in the wilderness, when Moses is really struggling to find water for so many people, God gives him this instruction and he says, "Go and strike the rock." And when Moses strikes the rock, water starts gushing out of the rock and it provides for the Israelites, and it satisfies the thirst of the children of Israel. Now, 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 4, it tells us, "And all drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ." And so the rock is typifying Jesus Christ, who would come later and be the one who gives life, through whom we can be satisfied, we can find the refreshing, we can find every resource we need for our spirit, our soul, and our body. And so Jesus is that rock of Exodus 17, from whom we receive all our needs. Now, once again in Numbers chapter 20, there was a time when people wanted water, and at this point God tells Moses to simply speak to the rock. Why speak to the rock and not strike the rock? That is because at this point the rock was struck once in Exodus 17. And so Jesus is that perfect sacrifice who died only once, and that death is sufficient. We do not require another sacrifice to meet our spiritual and all our other needs. And so the Bible teaches us that there are pictures or shadows of the cross in the Old Testament. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the cross. Father, we thank you that, God, you spoke to us, O God, about the cross way ahead in the Old Testament. Father God, we thank you, God, that nobody could fulfill the requirements of that substitute, God, that perfect substitute, but Jesus did. And God, that, Lord, he has died for us, O God, and that his death is perfect, God, washing away all our sins. God, we praise you and we honor you for what you have done, Lord, in full through your Son Jesus Christ. And God, even at this time, I pray that, God, the finished work of the cross, oh God, Lord, will release its power, God, in people's lives. God, Father, we trust you, Lord, for restorations, for transformation, for healing, oh God, and for miracles. We give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.